Hello everybody, I'm AndyTheDead and I'm back with another episode of Windbound. Last time we finished the first chapter, I died a couple of times, and now we're ready to set sails for the second chapter. So let's do just that. Alright, so we have an island right over there, let's check it out. And I've arrived on the island, but let me lower the sail. Just a moment. Yeah, there we go. And I think it's time to, you know, search for some supplies. Also, last time I've got this unbreakable bow, so let's put it to good use. This is going pretty well, but I'm afraid I'm going to flop it when he sees me. And I'm out of rocks. Oh, some rocks here. Right. And my grass sling is degrading. That sounds bad. Alright, missed that shot. I think I'm ready to move in for the kill. Well, let's give it another shot. Oh, more rocks here. Yeah, I'm going to hit you from as far as I can. And now you're dead. Fantastic. Let's loot ya. Oh, we've got some arrows back, yeah. Alright then, let's pick up some supplies. Picked up a bunch of stuff, including the gore horn or whatever it's called. Yeah, gore horn crest, yeah. And I think I need this to make... what was it? Oh, a shovel and a hammer. Well, let's begin with the shovel, I think it's going to be more useful. Alright. Now, let's get more hunting. And I've got an arrow back. That's always great. What do I need to make those arrows, actually? Oh. Oh, poop. That was not cool, dude. Alright, so what was I taking? Yeah, the arrows. Let's check this out. We need just some sticks to make basic arrows and... yeah, the blink feathers and... bones. Alright, let's make some basic arrows then. Made as many as I could, so now we need to find some feather and some bone. Feathers we get from the little bunny thingies. Yeah, there's one. Can we get it? We sure can. Well, the first one was easier. Well, screw you. Can I dig you out? Oh, that's as good. Alright, on to crafting some bone arrows. But we need more bones. I think it's time to explore up there. There is the proper way. Oh, it's the keys again. How many do I need this time? The clouds are long departed. The trees are barren. The seas turn against us. Ominous. Right, let's get back down. I said just a moment ago that I need more bones for making bone arrows. Do I have some in here? No, I do not. But let's store some stuff. I picked up some more sticks and I think I can dig these things up. Yeah, that's fantastic. And we found some clay. Can we make something with it right away? No? Yes? Do we have to wait? Do we have to find the recipe? No, we don't have a recipe yet, but I'm guessing we're going to find one down the line. Ooh, and a little bunny thingy again. Blink, was it? Yeah, let's shoot it with basic arrows. I couldn't shoot it properly, so I'm going to dig it out. There we go. And I think I should be making a fire so I can cook all that meat I found so it won't degrade. Let's do just that. Oh, and we can make a clay kiln, so we can make some pottery and when we find metal, some with these items. I need one more stick to make the fire rack. Right, let's get one item in cooking and see if I can find any sticks. So I couldn't find any more sticks around here. So I'm guessing we're going to have to do this one by one or just leave. But first, let's wait for the first one to cook. There we go, it's ready now. So let's eat something. Yeah, the generously roasted meat sounds good. Full health and stamina, that's great. But there is no point in waiting here, so yeah, let's get moving. And we're off to another island. Let's see if we can find something interesting. So the game does have a map function, but it's not much use yet. I think we're going to have to sail around. Let's do just that. And land ahoy, mateys. I think I see three islands. That's new. Yeah, let's keep heading there. No, it's rocks. It's just rocks. But there is an island right back there. Let's head there. It looks interesting. There we go. We made it. In one piece, I have to say. Let's just stop the boat right there. And off we go. Right. New island. New things. Hopefully we can find some sticks so I can make a bigger fire and cook the items, the meat, before it degrades more. And what's that? Is that the bamboo? Yeah. Yeah, it is. And I have no space again. Fantastic. What can we do about that? Let's get a fire going. And let's cook the big piece of meat. And now we've got some space. Three spaces, that will have to do. Oh, and what is that? New creatures? Planestalker. That sounds dangerous. Let's kill it. Hello. Yeah, it's spear time. Spear time for you, not for me. And I'm dead again. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Survivalist. It's the full Windbound experience as the game tells us. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Survivalist. Apparently, when you die in survivalist mode, you go back right at the beginning of the game. You lose all your story progress, you lose most of your items, specifically you lose anything that's not in the held items category. And honestly, I find that to be troublesome. So I'm going to give survivalist mode another try, and if that doesn't go well, I'm going to restart the game in storyteller mode and do all those things again, and then show some progress from there. So let's get going. Right, so let's visit that island over there again. And now that we're here, let's try and pick up as many resources as we can. And ignore those killer things. So, except for a few pieces of rocks and some patches of grass, I've picked everything I could on this little island. I also killed a couple of animals for meat, and now we're ready to get the first key of the second chapter. I'm going to have to play this really carefully. There we go, made it to the top, let's get the key. Those little cryptic messages are repeating themselves, I guess. Never mind, let's go down. So there we go, we're ready to leave. I'm armed with a stick spear that I can't yet upgrade to a bone spear because I need leather, which I'm going to make when we reach the next island. So I can build, you know, a campfire and a tanning rack or whatever it was called. So let's get going there. And that island over there at the horizon is our next destination. And I'm starting to believe that, yeah, I'm going to die again. Especially if those skin stalker or whatever they were called monsters are there again. And here we are, made it to the island. Now, first things first, let's start a fire. You know, a video game fire. Don't start real fires. And we can upgrade it right away. Fantastic. Now let's get to, yeah, making some leather and then cooking whatever meat we have. So while this cooks, let's explore a bit carefully. This place seems to have a lot of bamboo. That's going to be helpful. We can make some boat upgrades with that, and that will be nice, especially if we can make the boat go faster. Oh, and sticks, I see. That's always useful. Oh, another ox thing? Yeah, let's stay clear of that and grab the money obelisk. And then run for dear life. Also, let's try and hunt something. Yeah, that was an almost sneak kill. Made it back to the beach in one piece, picked up some bamboo, some grass, a piece of meat, some money. Now let's see if what we were cooking is ready. Yes, it is. So let's get to more cooking. And now to have a piece of leather, let's upgrade the spear. Very nice indeed. What else can we make as weapons? Oh, I could make some bone arrows. Yeah, let's do that. Arrows are really, really useful in this game. And I can't build, yeah, the tools I will need to harvest more things yet, because I need to, you know, kill the bigger animals. And we've got a bunch of boat upgrades. And, oh, we have some accessories as well. Wait a minute, we've got a boat fire. That sounds good. And a bamboo basket. Bamboo bucket. Misread that. Yeah, 5 spaces to put items in. That sounds good. and hull spikes and a bagrag. Oh, that's also nice, but we need the plane stalker horn. So we can make a bamboo deck. A bamboo mast that I don't know better. A bamboo canoe, that's also nice. Hulls and hulls. I've decided we're going to build a bamboo canoe. So let's do exactly that. Let's make some rope. Get next to the sea, build the bamboo canoe. Dismantle my, my old boat. Build a bamboo, a bamboo mast on the new boat. Now, what else can we build? Yeah, let's build the bamboo basket. Also, can I attach the grass hulls on the bamboo canoe? Let's check this out. No, I cannot. Oh, never mind then. Right. Are my things ready? Yeah, they are. So I think I'm done with this island. I don't see any bamboo having grown back. I think it's time to go and check out our new boat. Yeah, our next destination is going to be that island over there. Yeah, I can already feel it's a little bit faster than our previous boat, and it's definitely hardier. There we go, made it to a new island. Let's get exploring and let's hope that not everything is going to kill us. Also, let's store some items. There, now we have 6 spaces in the inventory. That's good. Let's eat something. Actually, let's eat 2 pieces of meat just in case we need to fight. Oh, and there's an old village here. Let's get exploring. When the storms die down, we search the shoreline for driftwood and build great pyres on the beach. That sounds like a hint. So money, more money, even more money, and some metal tipped arrows. Yeah, those are always good. And bone arrows, those are acceptable. All right, let's try and fight this thing. That went better than I expected. More money, more arrows. Yeah, this game is loading me up with supplies. Also, some raw truffle. That's always good. Those things cost a lot, but I don't think we will be able to sell them. At some point, I'm going to have to fight one of those things. You know what? That point has come. Screw it. If I die, I die. I'll start the game over in storyteller mode. There we go. Thank you, bow and metal tipped arrows. Yeah. And what do we have here? A plane stalker horn. I think I need that for something. Yeah, it's for the bag rack for the boat. Well, that's useful for sure, but not right now. And I'm out of space again. Fantastic. There we go, the game decided that I need to eat, so now we have space. And what's this weird thing here? Stamina shrine. Yeah, our stamina has been increased. That's absolutely great. Right, so I made it back to the boat, picked up all the supplies I could find in this island, on this island, except some bamboo trees over there. Yeah, let me get those real fast. Right, so now I picked up all the items I could on this island, except for a few rocks. Now let's see if we can do any upgrades on the boat. Well, I could build some things, but I don't have the space for it. I should build a bigger boat. Right, let's get sailing to the next island. I'm thinking we should go right over there. And when we get there, we'll see about the upgrades. And it looks like we found another of those key shrines. So let's grab that. Our love is dead. Our souls are broken, brittle, hollow things. As if the game wasn't dark enough already. Story-wise, I mean. Because otherwise it's very bright, colorful, and pretty. Right, let's get back down. Right, so Kara, our protagonist, decided to take the fast way down. It wasn't me, it was her, it's not my inability to control her, it was her choice, I respect that. Now let's get on with our lives. So, let's build a bamboo deck. But now we can't build a hull. That's great, I guess. Let's try and dismantle the boat so we can make the rest of the stuff. We go now, our boat looks a lot better. Let's see if we can put a little basket. We are going to need this. So a grass basket on this side, and can we put another one on the other? Yeah, we can. That's actually really, really good. So let's store some items. But first, let's build a boat fire. Let's upgrade it. And now let's get cooking while we're sailing. Yeah. That's actually really nice. We spent too much time sailing, so that's going to help. Now let's store those items. Store the feathers, store the grass, the sticks, the rope, the horn, and yeah, the rocks as well. Now let's get moving and let's hope and pray not to die. And I have to say this already. Feels a lot better, controls a lot better. Now, over there on the horizon, I see, the causeway place that we, turn in the keys. So, maybe perhaps... Yeah, let's ignore that and go directly the other side. I'll tell you one thing, this boat goes crazy fast. I like it, but it looks a little bit dangerous. And I think we found the third key shrine. So, yeah, it's a bad idea to end this chapter now. We could be farming a lot of more of this. But I'm going to do this just in case, you know, bad things kill me. Oh, this goes really fast. Stop. Right there. So, is my meal ready? Yeah, everything is ready. So let's eat that meat. And let's go grab that key. And once again, made it to the top. Let's grab the key. The taste is bitter, as sacred law dies. Only one path is left to fill the emptiness inside. Something went really, really wrong, didn't it, eh? Right. Let's get going to the causeway where we deliver the key pieces. Right, so this thing goes like crazy fast, it's dangerously fast. Oh, reefs. Reefs are bad. And we made it. No, don't jump off your boat, you crazy broad. We don't jump off of boats in this house. We crash them to the shore. There we go, much better. Now, same procedure, let's go deliver the key pieces. And one. And there goes the second. And here's the third. Go on, great altar of the sea, show us more about ourselves. Second crossing, Fury. Are we sure we're not dealing with grief? I said that in the last episode, but I'm having some doubts about it. So, people are worshipping this Kohlia thingy, and it goes at sea with them and sails with them. Then it keeps sailing with them, and they find some weird fishbone, I would say, artifact. And then they present that artifact to the sun and try to rule over land and sea or whatever? I'm guessing we'll find out. Right, let's go through the dungeon waters. Oh, I love my boat. Right, let's do this. Full speed ahead. Are we going to see the giant kraken again? Mr. Kraken, are you here? There you go. Yeah, we get it. You are that big cochlea thing we are worshipping. Are you gonna eat me? No, doesn't seem so. Oh. I almost made the boat fly. Yeah, possibly I should lower the sail just a bit. And now starts the hard part. Well, doesn't look that hard so far. Whoa. Yep. I was... Ah, crap. We went over that. But that is... What's going on with the reefs here? Yeah, I was mostly silent, and when I decided to speak, reefs appeared. And we're almost at the altar. Made it to the show. And also almost destroyed my boat. So let's see what offering we'll get this time. We have Gordel's Greed, that increases the amount of sea shards we gain. And also Arms of Immacle, a small increase in the number of held item slots. That's actually really good. For when we die, the only items we get to keep are the held items. And when I say held items, I mean those things in this top row here. Not the first one, the middle one. The other are bag items, we lose all of these. Right, so let's get our blessing. But I also don't want to lose my bow. I quite like my unbreakable bow. Can I keep two? Also, in a previous playthrough where I died and had to start all over again, I picked up the blessing that, you know, reduces the poison effects. But I can only have one blessing on me. Yeah, I think I'm going to keep the bow. Alright, time to get moving. And into the void we go. Also chapter 3. The war. So we made it to the third chapter, called The War. And yeah, this time things went better, but honestly I didn't explore as much as I would have liked. The game is pretty much this for 3 more chapters. It's find the key pieces and deliver them to the key shrine. Then move on to the next chapter until we see the ending and we see what happened with Kara's people and all that. I'm going to say that it's a very interesting game. I like it so far very much. And now that we've got a very, very fast boat, it's going to make things a lot easier for us. But the fact that survivalist mode is so brutal, yeah, I'm going to have to do something about that. If I die now, I'll have to play through all the first chapter, through all the second chapter, and then again here. But I should also farm a lot of things. I need to pick up items so we can craft more items and so on and so forth. So here's the deal. If I die one time, I'm going to do the storyteller mode. Yeah, I know, get good, you scrub, blah blah blah, all that stuff. But if I'm not going to die, then that's good. We're going to see the game played through survivalist mode, and I'm going to be a proud finisher of this game in survivalist mode. We will do all these things next time. Until then, stay safe and have fun.